Yeah, someone says that in stream.
Wow. All right.
I was like, all right, cool. Cool, cool.
Looking for inspiration. I don't know what I'm doing yet, but it's okay.
I need an action.
Back to the shady song.
What? Wow. Yeah, I think they were joking. Honestly, I'm not entirely sure if they were joking, but they could have been.
I think Pam's like ready to go on this one.
I have like 3 references.
Do you really? I've done no planning for this. Pam is like locked and loaded, ready to go.
I like cool. Yeah, like I don't know. I think I've had these stored up for a while, honestly. So.
Yo, Chaz, thanks for following, man. How you doing? I'm doing great today, man. Doing great.
Do I have on eyeshadow? Of course. I'm leader of, like, I'm the pimp daddy of all you hoes, so of course I have to have eyeshadow on.
Wow. Junie LeBlue, how you doing?
Yes, I'm happy ho for 9 months. Damn. Thanks for being so supportive, Pimp Daddy. Keep up the amazing art and community. Love your work.
Thank you, Shadow. How are you doing? Do you want to see any of my references? Do you think that will help?
I don't know. I have an idea. I'm not really sure why I'm going.
You're not sure why you're going this way? That's never a good thing coming from you.
It's not like really a funny thing. It's just, it's a really good picture. I'm like, okay. I don't know. I'm going to try drawing the scene. See what happens. I kind of want to like play up like style on this.
Okay.
Style piece.
Are you going lurking male while... or female?
I think male on this one.
Okay.
Lurking while I paint? Hey, no worries, dude. You want to do this though? Yeah, right on. Lurk away. Dang, look at my... That took me by storm. I'm doing my best though. What are you doing, Pam? You doing female?
Of course. For sure. Of course.
Yeah, I kind of want to like play up like angles and proportions on this one.
That'd be fun. I see that.
Okay, I have a really cool reference. I did a black and white of a long time ago.
Okay.
But I kind of want to like play it up even more. I wonder if he'll recognize it or not. I think I showed it off on stream before.
How long ago was it?
A while ago. I mean, I've shown old work before on stream.
Okay.
So I'm not sure. I don't know, necessarily.
Well, I'm sure it'll look great.
Hulk Faun? No, I mean, it's kind of Hulk-esque, though. For sure. It's like the real life embodiment of.
Oh really?
That's not Lou Ferrigno.
Huh?
That's not Lou Ferrigno. I think Scoobs would get this one. It's also not Brock or sorry. It's not what's his name? Braun Strowman.
It's not?
Not Braun Strowman. I was contemplating Braun Strowman.
Gosh, who? Would I not recognize it?
I mean, I literally just said his name by accident.
Oh. Okay, I think I heard it. I'm not entirely sure if I heard it, but I think I heard it.
I can.
Ken, do you not know how to cheer?
Beastie, you doing one too? Or are you working on your little secret project over there?
Heh
Editing videos? Are you really? I'm gonna work on that a little tonight. Oh, okay. Wait, why did he get timed out?
Who got Morbid. Timed out?
Morbid timed out, Ken.
I am obligated to time out fake cheers. Wow, Morbid. That's kind of great. Do you have like certain body parts that you know like you kind of struggle with the proportions of it sometimes, so like you'll draw it on another layer just to make sure you don't fuck it up?
Sometimes I don't have a go-to thing that like I always fuck up though, or like I struggle with. Do you?
It's always like a top arm for me.
Top arm.
Yes. God, I'm so mad because I just drew this on the wrong layer too. But like, if I have to draw like an overlapping limb, I guess I always draw it on another layer, because I always kind of fuck up the proportion initially, and then it gets fixed. But. Yeah, so like I always, if I have an arm on top,
Morbid is my minion.
Wow. Thanks, Ken. but yeah, so like I'm drawing this top arm right now, you know? So like I know like I might fuck up the proportions, so I'll draw it like on a separate layer so that I can adjust it easier.
Okay. We always get really quiet when we do these, the 90 minutes, you and I.
I know. It's because it's like you're actually thinking about, like, compositions and stuff, right?
Yeah.
So, it's okay, though. It's okay.
Oh, yeah, yeah, I'm not complaining. I think it's funny.
Got him. I want to know what this secret project is, Beastie.
Yeah, BC, sure, Pam. I think she'd love it.
Share care. Unless it's too private, then it's okay.
There it is. Ken got it.
Only took Morbid timing him out, right? I think I made the lower half too. Have this thing where I make torsos really effing long.
It's not a bad thing though, versus I feel like.
No, it has its own sort of segments, right? And if you can pull off the exaggeration, I think it looks really cool. But this is probably a touch too long.
I don't know. It looks damn it. Yours looks so good already. What the fuck?
Thank you. To be fair, I've had this reference saved for almost a year now.
Have you?
I just haven't had time to work on it. I have a few references saved. There's certain times I'll see, like, pictures or whatever, and I'm like, oh man, that would make a really great, like, Faun creature. I don't know why I like drawing them so much, but I do. Although, I tend to draw my Fauns a little bit more deer-like, which I've found out is a totally different thing, but whatever, I'm still calling them Fauns. See audio. I'll pam out DMT when I. Yeah, I want to see Misty. I want to see. Thank you for showing.
That's a damn good start, I think.
Thank you. Alright, what kind of horns should I put on her?
Deer horns, I like deers.
Maybe we'll go a little simple because I think the rest of her is gonna be kind of complicated. So.
The elaborate, like, ridged ram horns from one of the earlier references.
I definitely will put some sort of ridges on it because I really like that sort of texture on the horns.
Yeah.
That sounds bad. We're just gonna ignore that.
That's fine.
That's fine. This is fine, guys. This is fine.
This guy has such a weird shaped head.
Yeah. Oh, actually, I don't think I heard you then. That doesn't look like who I thought you were drawing.
Who do you think it was?
I heard Brock for some reason.
Brock?
Yeah.
Brock who?
Lesnar?
That's actually what it is, yeah.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Wait, maybe I'm not thinking of this right person then. Is he the one with that what emote?
The what emote?
Yeah. There's like I'll show it to you later. I'll show it to you later because this is like what to me he looks like, I guess. So.
The what emote? I'll show you. This dude. Looks like a fucking cartoon character.
Oh yeah, see, that's not what he looks like in my head. I think of... Hold on, let me... I don't know what the emote is called. Oh my god, I have to find the emote. I don't know if this is the right person or not. I don't remember whose emote. Is it one of Scoob's emotes?
Yeah, that's him. Yeah, it is Scoob's emote.
Oh, okay. Yeah, so that, like, expression is, like, what it is in my head of what he looks like.
Oh, okay.
That sort of, like, goofy exaggeratedness of it. So I guess that's why it didn't correlate.
I'm kind of taking like a caricature kind of route, I think.
I mean, what you have with what you show me, that looks really good. It didn't fit with what I had in my head because of that emote, I guess.
It's funny, like, I'm trying to like push the proportions, but I can't do it. Like, I just want to like correct things instead of like letting it go.
I can see that. I think that's kind of, in a way, like, part of your history and how you end up developing style. Like, there's just certain things that we like to do. And even when you try to correct it, sometimes you can't get rid of it, right?
Mm-hmm. Fucking horns on this dude. Don't what kind of horns, guys?
I think he should have the ram horns.
Actually, yeah, maybe.
It'd be so perfect for, like, his kind of role. How are your guys' spawns or cedars coming along? You guys doing good?
Check out so quiet. It's funny.
I know. I'm hoping that means you guys are like really enjoying whatever it is you're doing. And that you haven't all abandoned us.
I do it all for you. What's going on? I will make James proud. Oh my goodness.
Uh-oh.
Right?
What does that mean?
I don't know. Beastie Dabs, the devilish kind, maybe. Yours always already looks so good.
Aw, thank you. I'm kind of excited we did this one because I actually realized I hadn't drawn a font this year yet, and I kind of tend to do one every year. I just like haven't really had time since I haven't been concentrating on original work.
Yeah.
So,
get ready for next week.
Wait, did we decide what we're gonna do next week?
I think so.
Okay. I mean, either way, like the I think we're debating between a few, but I don't remember if we actually decided or not.
I think we did.
Okay.
Because I'm pretty stoked about one of the options.
I don't remember. I'll have to go look in our notes. It's fine, it's probably just me not remembering because of the way this week has gone.
Good, the drawing is definitely coming along. Are you playing? Maybe. This is more kind of like a rough thing. We're super early into the process here on this one. We're just kind of like doing our own Faun or Satyr drawings this evening.
Mm-hmm.
For part of the studies for the night. You should join in, Alpharia.
Hey, DHT. Morbus says I wanted to do Howard, but I can't move him up, so I can't give him the appropriate length of legs. Oh, no. I mean, that just means you have to do a new kind of Howard. Right?
I don't really know where I'm going with this, but bug.
Oh my god, that looks kind of awesome.
Like, what am I doing?
That's great. I kind of like seeing where you take some of these. I think it's cool. Like, your Murther from last week was amazing.
Got Got about an hour and 9 minutes. We got plenty of time, actually, still.
Yep.
Plenty of time.
Kind of like her expression. Just have the proportions were kind of off. What direction are you guys going, by the way, with your fawns? Are you guys doing more whimsical stuff? Are you doing more meme-y stuff?
Knowing our crowd we got here, probably more meme-y shit.
Oh, I can see that.
That's what I'm guessing.
Silver is going magical.
Okay.
Magical does not mean the return of certain feet hands, right?
Oh god.
Right, Silver?
What are you linking me here, Beastie? This holds the answer? Oh, I can't click on this stuff. Is this like copyrighted or? I'm not sure you're linking me, Beastie. Well, thanks for the idea. Memes all the way. Knew it. Beastie.
What?
He like linked me a video, but it's like music.
Oh no, it's got the copyright stuff on it.
Yeah.
Although, I mean, if we're not saving the VODs, then it kind of don't matter.
Yeah, I guess I gotta consider that then, because I feel like I'm so far gone in the VOD stuff now. I could probably consider what I'm gonna do with it.
Yeah.
I don't really know how much use people really got out of the VODs anyway. Maybe we could ask the chat.
I mean, you can look at your passive views too, right?
True. Let's see. That's true.
I know the Anatomy Jam ones got viewed quite a bit.
Yeah, that's fair. It was kind of cool having. I really wish the backup system, the highlighting and saving was way better on Twitch.
I mean, I wish if you. Right? I wish if you, like, added something to a goddamn collection, it actually just saved it, because, I mean, if you're going through the process of adding it to a collection, probably means you want to save it.
Yeah. Whoa! Sasha! Miss Thirsty!
Aww.
Dropping a raid on me. How you doing? Thanks so much for the raid. It's good to see you streaming again, too. What the heck? What's up, Emily? How you doing? JB1830, how you doing? Zarde, alone. X-Crayon?
Creon? X-Crayon.
Q-Ball Jamal? That's a great name. Welcome, guys. Welcome to the stream. I'm James, or Jay Hansen Art. If you're not following, aka Sasha. She's fucking awesome. Fantastic artist. Go show her some love, guys. I do portraits, I paint. You're actually coming in during a day that's kind of special. It's a Wednesday stream, which means we're doing study jam. Pam, please say hi.
Hello.
That's Pam. You guys may know her from Twitch. From such Twitch channels as twitch.tv/Pomodic. And we co-host study jam every Wednesday, 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific. We're actually doing studies today. We're currently doing a 90-minute kind of free-for-all. We're doing Faun and Satyr studies. So we did a bunch of stuff leading up to this. We did, like, rams and horns and goats, like the horns and the hooves and the legs and the bodies and stuff. And now it's kind of like, do your own thing for 90 minutes, and we show everyone's work up on stream after the timer's up. So I'm drawing a Brock Lesnar Faun.
I mean, in his case, would he be a satyr? Because he'd probably be a little bit more on the mischievous side, right?
Not maybe. Whimsical. Maybe. If you guys are kind of curious what I do, though, on stream, I do mostly paintings, mostly portraits, so stuff like this. A lot of wedding commissions. You know, a little bit of this and that. But if you're kind of curious, check out my Instagram. We're very wholesome here. We draw tits, too, like you can see right there.
We're very wholesome. We draw tits.
But yeah, welcome to the stream, guys. I'm on every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Saturday. And if you guys want to join in, there's a dual stream link you can click on. You can hang out with Pam's stream, too. And hey, JB and Alone, thank you for... Thank you. And Crayon, thanks for... Is it Crayon or Crayon? Thanks for following, too, man.
Hi, Emily. Hi, Sasha.
Thank you, Sasha. What are you working on today, Sasha? What were you working on stream? Almost says Greeks from the motherland. What's up, guys? Wholesome tits.
Wholesome tits. I mean, are there it's any like, other kind?
That's a fair point. Yeah, if you want to share anything you're working on, seriously, yeah, just get a link permit from Beastie, and we'll show it off on stream.
Hello, thank you so much for that follow.
Yeah, so Pam's kind of doing more of the traditional Faun. I'm doing kind of a weird thing. It'll be fun, though. We're having a good time
tonight.
You're
doing a James thing, and I'm doing a very Pam thing. That's what's going on.
Last week we did mermaids as a community in stream. That was pretty fun. Mm-hmm. Pam drew a really pretty mermaid, and I drew that.
You
Thor
drew the prettiest mermaid ever. Don't even. Okay, the prettiest freaking mermaid ever.
That's pretty good. Pisney.
No, hey, Sam, no, that is not gonna be. Who said that? Nara, I'm gonna nuke you.
Hey, Crayon and Zardy, thanks for following, guys. To all the people following tonight, thank you and welcome. Hope you're having a good time tonight. Would smash fat Thor mermaid? That was pretty special.
It might turn into a collaborative piece. We haven't fully decided yet.
Yeah, we're actually talking about it. I'm actually working on some better lines for it. And Pam actually may paint it as like a collaborative print. I don't really know if people would actually buy it or not, but it'd be kind of fun as a experiment.
Yeah. It'd be something a little unique in a way, right? So.
Yeah. Also, how's your, Sasha, you've been doing some conventions. You're up in Boston recently, huh? How'd that go? I'm actually from, well, outside of Boston. I didn't actually make it out to the convention, but...
Was it Anime well Boston, you. Or...?
Yeah, I think it was Anime Boston. I know Punto was out there.
Sam! Hello, Sam! How are you?
The most wholesome tits on Twitch. Thank you so much, Flo, for admiring my tits.
The most wholesome tits.
Drawing of Lucina from Fire Emblem. Ooh. Yeah. Pretty. I'll get you a permit. There you go. Show me. What you got for me? It's really a blast. It's my first time. Oh, no shit. You guys are both from, like, the New York area, right? Oh, that's really good. Holy shit. Yeah, guys, you're not following Sasha. Dude, check her out, man. Her painting is super,
beautiful.
Super good. Right?
Yeah, that looks actually, really beautiful.
I played, like, I think the original Fire Emblem or Fire Emblem 2 back in the day. So I don't actually recognize the character. I don't remember the characters, but... This looks fucking rad. Well, goddamn. Are you gonna be streaming more often, you think, Sasha? just a work in progress, nothing much. No, it looks really good, though, already. Don't worry, Beastie, it's okay. Mr. LA, Mr. Lala Hunger Service, how you doing, dude?
LA, hello, LA.
Oh, you're from Philly, okay. Do you do the Philly Comic-Con at all, or no? What's up, JB? Massachusetts is the 14th biggest state. Just 4 hours from New York. I know. I used to drive to New York every other weekend, man. Back in the day. Actually, not too bad of a drive.
Been lurking in meetings for the past 3 hours. I have made it here somewhere. Holy crap, why are you in meetings for so long?
Closer to Philly, but still in the East Coast. Right on. Trying to be more consistent after my break. It's nice to be back. Hey, yeah, I knew you took a long break. I didn't really want to, like, pry or ask. Sometimes it's good to take a break from social media or Twitch and stuff. We were kind of talking about that earlier on stream, too.
Yeah.
Stepping away from Twitch and whatnot. But I hope it was a good break for you. It's good to know that maybe things will be a little more consistent for you going forward. So you definitely have a really good stream to hang out in.
Yeah. In My Secret Life, you're on the board of directors for a magazine. Are you really? Lies. Are you? I mean, actually, I could see this.
Never done Philly Comic Con. I thought about it, but the table was expensive. I remember. Okay. I know Siege did Philly Comic Con. What was Siege's experience? Remember?
I think he said he liked it, but I think he wasn't sure if he was gonna go back or not.
Oh. Philly Comic Con would be an easy one for me to do if I could.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's like a 4.5-5 hour drive for me.
Okay. Oh yeah, so I think for Siege, like, he commuted like an hour each way, so I think when you do that with a con, it's kind of rough.
Yeah. So maybe if you did it next year, like, I could get a B&B or something with him.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
I'm kind of liking this piece already.
Yeah? Good.
Yeah, my lines are fucking flowing right now.
Good, good, good.
West Philadelphia? I heard of a friend of mine was born and raised there.
Oh, who said that?
Flow.
Smurf says Philly Comic Con will be like a 15-minute walk. Oh, that's nice. Mm.
Sasha said that it was a longer break than anticipated, but it was well needed. I feel ready to go now. Good. Awesome. Honestly, sometimes just like taking like a night off, like for like mental health and like stepping away is good.
Yeah, I agree.
I'll admit, like, I have a convention, Pandas too. We're both going to be tabling at Denver Comic Con, Pop Culture Con.
Are you sure about that? You don't sound very certain about this.
Wow, okay. Wow. No, but the thing is, like, I have so much work to do in preparation.
Mm-hmm.
And I have commissions to do. And it's like, man, like, should I really be streaming tonight? You know what I mean? But it's, you know, like, sometimes you gotta just kind of weigh, like, what's going on. Like, streaming's, you know, still obviously, I think, really important for both of us, right?
Yeah.
You know, and it's tough. It's really a tough balance sometimes between personal life, other projects, being an artist, being a streamer. Like, how do you find that balance, you know?
Yeah, I agree. I think it's really difficult sometimes. But I also think that, like, what I worry is if you get into the habit of canceling streams because you can't meet, you can't balance your schedule, you know, that'll always sort of be your go-to instead.
Yeah, that's fair.
Yeah, so partly, like, I kind of want to try to avoid that just because, like, I don't want to build that habit, right?
Yeah, that makes sense. That makes sense.
But I get it too. I mean, it's you know, instead of me skipping streams, I'm skipping workouts, so that's not even any better.
That's actually what I did. I skipped working out today.
Yeah. So, I mean, like, there's... I think we'll find it eventually. I think, like, yeah, there is, like, a balance to be had there, and we just gotta figure it out kind of thing.
Yeah, that's fair. That's fair.
Yeah. That's all. It'll get there. Dude, I kind of fucking love this.
Dude, it looks super, super good. Honestly, if you're on my stream and not on Pam's stream, checking out what she's working on, it's super, super good. Cubal Jamal. What's up? Dude, I fucking love your name.
That is a very cool name, actually. Sasha says, I agree. It makes it easy to make a habit. Yeah, I mean, like, I did that with the gym, and I totally lost my, like, gym dedication because of it, and so now I'm trying to fix it, you know? And, like, I mean, I think it was last Thursday I was definitely tempted to just, like, not stream.
Yeah,
I mean, because I was feeling so tired, and, like, you know, the whole con thing has definitely been a little bit stressful, like, this sort of, like, last bit of it. Yeah,
I can see that.
So... yeah, it was like, oh, but then, like, I kind of just made myself. And honestly, I'm really glad that I did, because I ended up really enjoying it. And I actually got a decent amount of work done, too, so. I don't know. But I do think there are times where it's worth, like, I think there was that one day where we decided, instead of doing study jam, we...
To work on stream?
Yeah, and I think that's kind of a good compromise, too. You know, and
I think so, too.
Do that every now and then, like, not all the time, but every now and then, like, I feel like our audience would understand, I hope.
Yeah, well, I mean, I think it's, we kind of opened up to the idea, too, of other people, like, working along with us, and, like, being able to actually, like, show other people's work and stuff, too, on what would traditionally be, like, a normal, like, study, like, focus night.
So. Yeah, that's true, so there's kind of some benefits to it.
Yeah, Introvert, thanks for following, dude, appreciate that. BC says, amen to that. Fuck, like, throw school in there, too.
Wait. BC just said, I want to live in the city, preferably with the girlfriend, so I got... Are you there already, Beastie?
Wow, BC getting serious over there.
Oh my god, BC's growing up, guys. My heart.
My heart.
Sorry, BC, we treat you like the baby, and I kind of totally think of you as the baby of the group. Although, I actually thought you were much older, and we found out recently that you're not what age I thought you were. And so, I mean, in a way, you kind of are the baby of the group, so I guess
he is a baby.
He is a baby. Sorry, BC.
The baby.
Beastie unleashing the beastie. Oh god.
That sounds so wrong.
They thought you're in your 20s. Do I look older? No. It's not that. I think it was just more we thought you were older.
Maybe I mean, I'm actually not surprised, right?
Yeah. I mean, maybe it's our own selfish denial, because like that just makes us even older in a way, so.
BC, you've grown so much. Get an inflatable girlfriend, they're way more convenient for most city apartments. Wow. It's actually not a bad point.
Wow, guys, no.
Make sure you thoroughly clean and disinfect.
Oh my god.
What?
Can we not? No.
What?
Do not corrupt Beastie more than he already is.
No, stop. Free!
What color hair should we give her, guys?
Where's Ellie? Ellie, hair color choice.
You said I'm not allowed to do beach anymore, right?
Yeah, no more beach. Come on.
Hi, Aldernon!
Wooded background.
Do you want a wood background?
Sky City for the Faun.
I don't want a creative city background for sure.
Whee! Only if the inflatable consents.
Wow. I mean, at least you're teaching about consent. I don't know.
That's good. Yeah.
Green hair. Venus has green hair. Could do that. Make her blend in with the trees. Hello, wife. How are you?
Venus, how the fuck you been?
Who was that? Brandon, thank you so much for the follow. Gonna get ready for bed. Bye, Sasha.
Sasha, thanks for coming by. It's really good to see you, too. I hope things are going well for you. Why is this back to Christmas music?
It really, really wants to play Christmas music on your stream. Like, really.
It's so weird. Last time I changed it, someone was like, I really like that music. Change it. Really? You really want me to play this shit?
It's, like, I love Christmas music, but it's not Christmas.
I know. Hey, Venus. What's going on? Want to get you for Xmas? I got you a healthy dose of the clap.
Oh,
and some,
well, there you go.
Some fresh pussy pics.
Oh my god.
Art is my Daniel? What's up, man?
Oh, god.
It's very non-offensive and chill Christmas music, so it's okay. Okay. Alright, I guess we're on the same page.
Well, there you go.
Nice. For a burning sensation. Came out as a boy today. I'm tired. May I just chill here? Yeah. You're welcome to chill here. Welcome to the stream. Oh no, I'm humming it.
The Christmas music?
Yeah, oh no.
Oh, that's great. That's great.
Venus, how you been, Venus? Who's that? Comrade Goku. Thanks for following, man.
I want that to be lighter.
Silent night. Holy night.
Also, I didn't know you weren't even in your 20s. Oh, right, Venus? That's what I felt like. Venus also didn't know that that BC is not in his 20s.
Right. Yeah, I get that same thing all the time, Beastie. Don't worry.
Shush. I think it's sort of like, I don't know. I think there's a little bit of like that expectation on with, because we're all around the same age-ish, right? And then the people who are younger, they're all also kind of around the same age-ish. So like, I think just the simple fact that BC is just a little bit younger than we anticipated.
That's fair. That's fair. Nera says, change the playlist. Is this a Viking Faun? Venus asked. Kinda.
It's a wrestler Faun.
I'm having a really good night tonight, for sure. It's been fun.
Good. God.
Good.
Also, James, I've drawn, like, tree backgrounds so much recently that I'm not even using a reference for this.
Yeah?
Yeah, this is, like, something that I don't think I would have, like, ever crossed my brain to have been able to do, but...
Oh, yeah.
I'm kind of just, like, meeing this.
This song is so ridiculous.
I can't believe you started singing Christmas music.
I think Nera really liked it.
I mean, was it as good as the infomercials? When you sing the infomercials?
877 cash now?
Yes.
If you need a structured settlement, then you need cash now. Stop right there.
My music is really intense right now. It's gotta match, like, she's, you know, it's gotta match this Faun. She's about to go fuck some shit up, okay?
Jorge says I'm not using reference either. Yeah?
Nice. Well, not necessarily nice, but I guess if you feel confident enough for that.
GG Wentworth, 877 cash now. It's my money and I need it now. Greedy fuck. doing okay, Venus, he said. Venus says she's doing well.
Oh, good, good. Sorry, I kind of zoned out and missed that.
Me too. Is anybody else watching that show, Chernobyl, on HBO? I know Pam's watching.
Am I? Or am I just working through it? I don't know.
Wow.
I think that works. It's a little bit of overlap there. Alright, let's figure out some of this. Time for my favorite part. Gradients.
Bum bum bum. Favorite commercials were the free credit report ones. Those are pretty good too. Venus is doing A-okay.
Yay!
No spoilers. We won't spoil Q-Ball. Well, I mean, it's based on real life events, so I guess if you know what happens, it's kind of out there.
Kind of. Well, I don't know, but then they actually kind of threw some random stuff in there too, right? So.
Did they?
Yeah. Well, I remember the what we saw from the after behind the scenes thing last night.
Like vaguely skirt around it without revealing. By the way, Jamal, thanks for following. I appreciate it, man. Also, Paul says HBO shows other than Game of Thrones. Yeah, they had the best show on TV called Barry. Which you guys should all be watching Barry.
They're also gonna have a TV show based off of Philip Pullman's Dark Materials book soon, which I hope to God is good. Hi Vibes! How are you?
Oh shit, what's up, Vibes? I was gonna say, like, that's not really much of a spoiler. Like, yeah, they kind of created, like, a fictional character.
Okay. I didn't know, I just wanted to be safe.
Okay. No, I mean, I got you. I think that's okay to reveal. It's like, I mean, you gotta assume that they're not always gonna have every character, like, based out of history.
True.
You know a drag queen that used the 877 Cash Now commercial in her set? Really? Kind of amazing, actually. In her set.
Oh, wow. There's 41 minutes left still.
We got a lot of time.
Holy crap.
My favorite commercial was the Credit Man commercial. What's that, DK? You've watched TV in 6 years. Man. Well, she...
Wait, do you not watch shows at all, or do you just not watch live TV? Because I actually find that a lot of people don't watch TV anymore. Like, they don't watch live TV, but they'll watch, like, shows and stuff. But Dan says 41 minutes, thank God. Live TV. Okay. Yeah, I barely watch... I don't think I've... Well, no. I've watched live TV only because of sports lately, but that's it. I rarely watch shows when it's on. Although, James tends to ditch us whenever Oak Island is on, so maybe you still watch live TV?
It's actually... No, I always watch it recorded.
Oh, you do? Okay, so I guess not a lot of people watch live TV anymore.
I mean, I would be watching Game of Thrones a lot, but I'm usually caught up somewhere else.
Wow! I mean, come on, it's not even that good right now, so...
Whatever, still Game of Thrones.
Venus says, I love those books when I was little, Venus. The movie just... Oh god, the movie was terrible. You saw The Golden Compass, right?
Yeah. I'm pretty sure I saw it.
Yeah, so that was based off of, like, one of my favorite, childhood books. And it's an amazing story. Like, it's seriously a really, really amazing story. And they completely butchered it in the movie. The movie was terrible.
Yeah, I think I watched some of the movie. I never actually finished it.
Yeah, and so they're making it into a TV show now.
Oh, okay.
So there's like, I'm kind of excited because, what's his name? Is it James McAvoy?
Yes.
He's in it.
All right.
So I'm kind of like, oh, maybe this will be really good.
That'd be good.
Right?
Speaking of history, have you seen Narcos? I saw the first season of Narcos, which I really love. And I started watching season 2, which I was enjoying. But I typically watch TV, like, while I'm working or, like, painting, so it's really heavily subtitled. It's really hard for me to watch these days. Mm-hmm. So I have to actually pay attention. I can't just put it on the background.
Same. That's why my anime consumption has depleted so much.
Speaking of, you started watching One Punch Man again, huh?
I did. I watched 3 episodes of Ken the other day, and it was pretty... It's like the only time I'm actually going to be able to watch anime. Because I'm sitting down on the couch, and it was pretty funny.
Yeah, it's pretty good, I think.
Watchmen looks good.
Yeah, Watchmen looks interesting.
Watchmen looks
good. I'm a big fan of the movies, the Watchmen movie.
I'm curious to see how that turns out. I kind of want to watch the movie again, because I don't remember a lot from it.
Yeah, the movie's really good.
It's been so long. I remember liking it, and that's it.
It's really well adapted. A comic. Okay.
Yeah, we should maybe put that on for a movie Monday one day.
Yeah, I'd be down for that. Jorge says 10 out of 10 from Narcos before the third season. Yeah, I heard the third season came out, but I didn't really hear much about it. Interesting. Mm. This is really fun.
Yeah? I'm glad you're enjoying. I'm having a lot of fun.
Good.
I kind of love doing color comps. It's funny because I never would have done this before.
Live TV is really annoying. I don't really like, watch it like live, but I'll usually give it like a 30-minute buffer so I can skip ahead with my DVR.
And avoid commercials?
Yes. Absolutely.
That's kind of the annoying thing sometimes with YouTube TV is that they'll replace the original commercials from the DVR version with like digital ones, and you can't skip the digital ones.
Like, that sucks.
If it's pre-recorded, you can just, you know, hit skip, 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 but the digital ones you can't skip at all.
Mm.
One Punch Man hype! The fantasy studies y'all been doing look so fun. Oh, thank you, Venus. They've been a lot of fun, honestly. They've been a lot of fun.
Been really cool.
Miss Venus, what color should her eyes be? I'm gonna wife privileges. Let her pick all the colors.
Do you doing line work for the fucking ram horns?
Oh my god. The detailing you've put in so far is kind of insane. Holy shit.
It's super fun.
That looks really good.
Thanks. I speak Spanish too, though, so watching anime, kind of like, you see it or you don't. Yeah, that's fair. Yo, Span, what's up, man? Yeah, new badges. You like my new badges? Pretty good, right?
They're top. He paid top of the line, you know, for those badges. Spin should be very, very proud of them. So apparently we're going with yellow eyes because both Sam and Venus said yellow at the exact same time.
All right.
Punto, what color the eyeshadow should it have and the lip gloss? No eyeshadow. She's not a whore, guys.
No, get the whore makeup on, okay?
No, she's like a nature-y person, though.
No. Whore makeup or get the fuck out. What's the point?
Wow. I will not.
Who watches The Watchmen? Dr. Manhattan.
Go with blue, one eye blue, and the yellow one with blue with a brown spot. Are you trying to make this Faun look like James?
that's a good looking eye color, I think. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I like how he was so specific. Like, if he had just gone blue, I wouldn't have thought of it. But he was so very specific with that.
How you been, Spin?
Alright.
You can say the shadow is the ashes of her enemies, the eyeshadow. Yeah.
Maybe.
She's pretty smexy.
Is she?
Yeah.
Have I pulled off the smexy vibes?
I think so.
Good.
You're busy, Spin? Super busy, yeah? What you been up to, man? How's the site launch and stuff going?
Nara says doesn't look Pisney.
Yeah, I'd say Pisney is not really something I'd describe today.
Nara, just get out. I kind of think her skin tone should be a little darker.
I love that Pisney's taken off.
I hate you so much. I hate you so much. Pam plus, yeah, Venus. But imagine what James plus Disney is then.
Pisney.
Fucking A, Marvin.
What's up, Jimbo? I need to draw more girls with nods. Do it up. Do it up. The site's going good, getting a bunch of traffic. Dude, that's sick. That's sick. I always see your stuff on IG too. Like, you seem like you're killing it right now.
I know, I'm pushing it. You're fine. You're fine. I just hate that this is a thing now.
Welcome back, Beastie. We're getting quite a bit more content. Nice. So, 24 publishers now under. Just under 400 titles. Jesus Christ, wow. Man. Close to 40 publishers? Well, over 40 titles? That's insane. Dude, how stoked are you right now? Like, all just kind of, like, coming full circle.
That's pretty fucking cool.
Right? Moving forward instead of back, I'll take it. Hell yeah. By the way, guys, 31 minutes to go. 31 minutes to go.
How are you liking yours? I think it's kind of amazing.
I don't really know what to think at the moment, but it's fine.
You know, yeah, you've never really done like the whole like fantasy creature stuff too, huh? This is all like kind of new to you. I think you're doing, I know like it's you know, out of your norm, but I actually think you're doing a fantastic job with it.
Thanks. See, Pam, I took the compliment.
Wow! Is it only because you came up with the whole Pisney thing, so you're like, I'll just take the maybe. Whole compliment then?
Maybe. Have a good day working on my comic. Hey, right on, man. You're on the podcast too, working on those episodes. Jesus. You're like on the ball. I'm happy for you, man. It's been like a long time coming, I feel like. Because we've been talking about this for like well over a year now.
Cannot achieve your full creative potential. What are you drawing, Polish? Polish says cannot achieve my full creative potential because of Toss.
Oh God. Life's going well, dude. Life is going really well. I'm prepping for a convention end of the month. Got two, potentially three cons planned for the year. Getting new prints, new work done. Staying busy, man. Trying my best. Add some eyeliner to him? Sure. Got it.
Who said that?
Alex the Fluffy Sheep.
Okay.
Lena says, I'm using a ref, but I'm low-key impressed with myself for now. Dude, I can't wait to see. I'm actually really stoked to see everyone's work on this. I never get off the ball. Maybe to sleep. I've been working on it for almost 5 years, almost every day. Jesus Christ,
wow.
Man. Thanks, Venus. Yeah, we're kind of fucking around here. Enjoying it, though. Am I going to go to SDCC? Probably not, man. I didn't apply for it. I also don't think I'd actually get in.
I would not recommend SDCC, considering it would have been, like... I feel like you needed, like, way more con experience before we even both try to attempt that. Because I think we'd die.
What was that? What was that? Hmm? Yo, Katie Makes Art, thanks for the raid.
Aww.
What are you doing? Oh no, Coyotes, that's an amazing name. Vok Kills Aaron, what's up, man? Nova, welcome back. What's up, guys? How we all doing? Katie, what's going on? How you doing? Welcome back to the stream. How you doing? How's your night going? Welcome, welcome. If anyone is new here, I'm James. This is Pam on the other line over there. Say hi, Pam.
Hello.
You're joining us on one of our special nights. It's Wednesday, which means it's study jam night. It's a weekly study series. It's all community-based. So in case you guys want to draw along, we run these every Wednesday at 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific. And we're doing like fantasy creatures. So we're actually did a bunch of studies leading up to this last 90-minute study kind of free-for-all. We're studying Fauns and Satyrs today. So I'm kind of doing my own thing. I'm doing a Brock Lesnar Faun or Satyr. I don't know why. But yeah, this is a 90-minute kind of just draw session. There's a Discord server in case you guys want to jump in and see all the references. If you want to share your work, you can share it on the Discord server too. We actually do critiques if you request it, and we show everyone's work off at the end of the study night, which is super, super fun. And yeah, we've been doing this for about a year and a half, so if you guys want to get involved, join Discord and hit the dual stream link. Also, Sam, I don't know if I said hi to you earlier, but how you doing, Sam? Also, Katie, what are you working on tonight?
Marvin. Polish says, I feel like my piece would be a lot more impactful if I could draw nipples. Draw them after stream. Like, after you post them. Although, I'm a little bit scared as to why you said that.
Doing well, worked on a commission and made my sub badges finally. Hey, that's awesome. Nice. If you want to share a link to your commission you're working on, just make sure you get a link permit from a mod. But I'd love to take a peek at it. Jam and Pam, bless. That's all good, Jimbo. Yeah, don't worry about it, man. It sounds like you got a lot of... you got going too. Brock Lesnar doesn't look happy. Probably not, because you can turn into a Faun.
Okay, yeah. Actually, Ori just mentioned something. Do not draw nipples, guys.
Oh, yeah. No nipples, no genitalia.
If you do draw nipples, you have to censor them. So if you're doing it traditionally, take a little post-it note or something and stick it right on that nipple. But if you guys post anything with nipples or genitalia or anything of that sort,
it will be deleted.
And that will be asked to repost with a censor.
Yeah, we can't show it on stream, so.
Sorry, I totally forgot about that.
Has there been a draw-along stream that's been, like, a favorite so far? I mean, we've been doing it for so long. I mean, I really enjoyed doing the anatomy studies. Like, we spent the first almost a year just doing human anatomy from head to toe.
Mm-hmm.
We did portraits. We did unique body series, kind of where we did, like, different body types, sizes, shapes, musculature. We even did like skin tone studies and stuff too. Like that was all really, really good. I've actually really enjoyed the current ones because we kind of started doing like a creature study thing where we're doing animals like every week, but it's kind of gone into doing more fantasy stuff now too. So like this week was Fauns and Satyrs. Last week we did mermaids. The week before that we did dragons. That was pretty fun.
Yeah.
And I don't know. I think it's just really entertaining because the way it's set up currently, when we do these kind of like 90-minute free-for-alls, it lets everybody take all the lessons that led up to it earlier in the stream or earlier streams for that matter. And it's kind of like, you just kind of create and do whatever you want, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's really loose. It's really, really fun to do.
Yeah, these have seriously, like, I mean, I wasn't joking earlier. I was so looking forward to this part.
Yeah. And yeah, they've been really, really fun. No nips or shadow
no
realm.
No nips.
Hard to draw a good nipple. You're not wrong, Spin.
Sorry about the 2-foot long nipple on my sketch flow, please. We're just gonna ban you now, okay?
Hey, that looks great, Katie. That's really nice. I like that a lot.
Oh, that's
cute. How you feeling about it? Yeah, right?
That's
super
really,
nice.
Really cute.
Are you all finished with it? Are you still working on it? That's really well done, though. It's got a nice style to it, too. Pressure was on. Is that a dab right there? You dabbing on me? Kind of like clean all this stuff and do it all over again. I'm super anal about this.
You're so, like, yeah, you're pretty, yeah, actually, no, you are, with your line work. But I don't think it's a bad thing, either. It's a good thing. Who is that? Oh my goodness, Young Khan, thank you so much for the host. How are you? How was your stream? Oh, and there's the raid! Thank you so much for the host/raid. Hello, welcome everyone. I'm Pomada. We actually just got done with that whole spiel on your end.
That's all good.
Oh my gosh. Hi, is it Javi? Rotting Jackal, what's up guys? How was your stream, Young? What did you do today? For anyone who is new coming in, my name is Pomada. I am a traditional digital artist, and actually, today is it's special weekly special stream. I don't know what to call it, but every single Wednesday I do a dual stream with Jay Hansen Art. Say hi, James.
Hello.
And we kind of do these in like a study stream, a community study stream format. We've been focusing on creating mythological creatures, and right now I'm doing a faun, and then James is doing a satyr, I guess, right? I don't know.
Something like that.
Either way.
Something like that. I don't fucking know what we're doing.
It looks fucking fantastic. So either way. So if you guys are interested in sort of checking out both our channels, just do !SJ and it'll give you a link to see it. And then if you guys ever want to participate with us, we do these studies every single week. So there's a Discord dedicated just for that. Hi, Young. Hello. Jay Hansen. I heard his name earlier today. Who did you hear it from? James, you're
That's
famous.
Me. That's
you're
me.
Famous. Are you also an art streamer as well? Carson drew it.
Oh. Oh, nice.
That's so sweet. Carson is so sweet.
That's awesome, man.
With an apostrophe. Thank you so much for the follow. How are you? Carson. I can see Carson. We're both fairly familiar with Carson hanging out in his streams, and also his lovely significant other. You make emotes. Nice. Will you do
that
today
cool.
as well?
Emotes, hey, Galactic Raptor. Thanks for following, man. Appreciate that, sir. We have 20 minutes left, by the way. I'm going to take a super quick bathroom break.
Excuse you. You're not allowed to do that.
Yeah, it's happening. Entertain the chat.
What? No, not fair.
I'll be right back. Enjoy okay, Brock right. Lesnar.
Oh man. What kind of were you working on emails today, Young? What were you doing? Also, if you want to drop a link to whatever it is you did on stream, you're more than welcome to. You do need a permit from a mod, so whenever you're ready, just go ahead and ask them for that. Javi and Galactic Raptor, thank you so much for the follow, guys. Thank you. Oh, don't worry. Okay, cool. I always want to give people the option, especially if they're so kind enough to, like, you know, drop a raid or anything like that. Spin, thank you so much for the bits. You're such a sweetheart. Thank you. You make 5 to 10 emotes every day? Holy shit. How do you make so many so fast? Perchance you take merch design commissions? It depends on what it is. Is it Doxmia? It depends on what it is. If you are interested, this is the link to my Trello. So you can kind of see where my pricing is at. If you are looking for something a little bit simpler, we can obviously adjust. But it'll depend. I'm only taking 5 commissions this year, too. So I think I only have 2 slots left, just FYI. You hit 3,000 emotes this month. You hit 3,000 emotes this month? Oh my god. Wait. I mean, I'd kind of really like to see your emote portfolio. Holy crap. Do you know Psycho Mochi? Because Psycho Mochi makes a lot of emotes really fast too, but I don't know if she's ever made that many in a month before. So hard to find good artists accepting multiple commissions. Send me a DM or an email, Doxima. The five email slot is flexible. Or sorry, email slot. The 5 commission slot is kind of flexible. The only reason I limited it to 5 this year is because I'm doing 4 to 5 really large conventions. So I don't want to overwhelm myself.
My goodness.
Workaholic.
I feel so much better.
Hello.
Oh, I feel so much better. Oh.
Wow. Excuse you. Can you keep that off camera? This is a PG stream.
Oh god.
Oh my gosh. Oh. I'm guessing that was a good pee.
Oh yeah, man. Between the coffee and then like I've been drinking so much water.
Young says you must be 30 ounces lighter. Is this true?
Minimum, Young. I feel good though.
Oh my god. So Young apparently is an emote artist and makes 5 to 10 emotes every day.
Oh damn, that's awesome, dude.
Like what? I think my hands would fall off, right?
That's kind of crazy. Hydration, that's right, Katie. What's up, Cho? Welcome back, man.
Hi, Cho. And welcome back, Snake Eyes. Yeah, we normally go to like 9 p.m. now, actually, with these studies. We've been getting some really good stuff on it.
Raptor says, no problem, I love making art myself. The more people I can find that also love it, the better. Aww. That's awesome, man.
That's really cool.
Yeah, if anyone is new, we're working off our Study Jam Discord server, but if you are new to my stream and you want to join my Discord, there's definitely channels on there to share artwork. If you want critiques, you can actually post in the work in progress section. This actually goes for Pam's own Discord, too. So if you guys are new over there, you can join Pam's Discord as well. If you request critiques, people will generally give you feedback. If you just want to share work in the finished section there, too. It's all there for you. But yeah, we'd love to see your work, man.
Yeah, that'd be cool. We definitely I like browsing the art section on my Discord, like whenever I'm yes. like, kind of bored. You know?
That's really fun.
Yeah.
Kay says, alright my dude, gonna go to bed. Hey, have a great night. Thank you for coming by again too, Katie. It's good to see you.
Your buddy Jesse shot you a link a couple. Oh, that's so sweet of him, thank you. Thank you so much for stopping by. I really, really appreciate it. Venus says you've gone so much faster. You got these colors down like nothing. Oh, thank you, Venus. So this is actually, I've started doing more concept sketching. So I'll spend a couple hours actually just doing concept sketch first. And then I'll go back and do like cleaner line work and everything. So this is just sort of me plotting things out. It makes things a little bit easier long term.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna try something.
What are you trying?
What are you buying? What are you selling?
Yeah, no worries. You can also if you want to do the cowgirly, you can just click on the link that says slutty. Wow.
Slutty jam?
Slutty jam, guys. Slutty dash jam. Jesus Dude, I have Christ. The worst, like, fucking... like, freaking 40
you kiss your, you kiss your mother with that mouth?
No, why would I kiss my mother?
Because you love her?
I don't know. Oh, no, my family's not like that. We barely hug.
Oh.
Okay. Hello, gotcha. Infinity Gauntlet. You came here in a snap. Like that. Silas, excuse you? No, Silas, it's pardon.
Pardon?
do I like... Yes, I like this process much, much better. It's actually what I've been doing for the last, like... full illustrations that I've been doing. I've all done concept sketching and color mapping with them first before I even got into like clean line work and correcting anatomy and stuff like that. at least what was the other one that I did?
Piss me?
No, fuck you. No. I think it was Tits bring the clits. That's what it was.
Yeah, tits bring the clits, guys.
Yes, that was the one. Oh my god. Yeah, I caught all the last ones you done when you were already rendering. Yeah, it's honestly, it's made the rendering process a lot faster too, because I already know what I'm gonna do kind of thing. Oh man, look at that heavy black.
Yeah, hell yeah. Young Khan, really thanks for following, bro. Good to see you here. Yeah, I figured like really there's really no reason not to put like more like a comic style ink into it, right?
I remember who Young Khan is now. I remember he tagged you on Twitter, right? Black Graph and We the Crew. Thank you guys so much for those follows. Thank you.
Spin Dude, have a good night, man. Also, congratulations on all the fucking success you on this kind of like really ambitious project that you're working on. It's super cool to see it paying off for you, man. Yes, sir. Nice art. Thanks, dude. How you doing, Colin?
My shoulder's like hurting.
Yeah? How come?
I don't know. I think it's because I went running yesterday. And you know, running on pavement is more impactful than like treadmill. So I think it's just, you know.
I feel you.
Venus says, have you ever tried thumbnailing? I tried to get used to it, but I'm not sure how much of a difference it's made.
I don't thumbnail very much.
No, I don't thumbnail either. I should do it more, but I find that normally whatever I see in my head kind of works out for the most part. And so this is my version of thumbnailing.
I mean, it works though, right? Like it's still effective. Javi, thanks for following, dude.
I think so. I hope so. Anyways. thank you.
You tend to like find a workflow like a thumbnail color kind of layout that tends to work pretty quickly. I think.
Yeah, so yeah.
You end up like it's thumbnailing, but you end up kind of just moving ahead with it earlier in the process. I feel like.
Yeah, no, I agree with that. And also, I think sometimes, like, if I do a good enough job with the background, sometimes I end up using it altogether and I just clean it up even more for the final thing. So I think that's also why it's kind of made me a little bit faster with the rendering process, too. Because I've already, like, gotten a good majority of it figured out.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Everyone has their own little process. Oh, yeah, that's true. Actually, how do you plan out your stuff? Do you just sketch? Or what do you do?
Yeah. I think I kind of thumbnail, I guess, when I think about it. But I usually stick to a sketch that comes pretty quickly. I don't usually, like, explore a lot of ideas.
Okay.
I think I kind of come to, like, the conclusion, like, or the direction I want to go with pretty early on.
Yeah, I'm kind of the same way.
I do a lot of portrait work, too, so it's kind of like... I'm working off a reference a lot of times, one to one, so it's, it doesn't really give me like the freedom per se to kind of deviate that much.
Okay.
But like if I do like more, how the fuck did my brush change randomly? Okay.
It's got a mind of its own.
Right. But if I end up doing more like personal work, like that Vega piece, then like yeah, I'll definitely kind of sketch it out. I think my sketch process comes from, I generally have a pretty good idea of what I want to do with a piece.
Mm-hmm.
And then my refinement comes with all the fucking line layers I do.
Yeah, okay. That makes
sense.
And
I'll work through a pose just by doing another line pass, then changing proportions or changing anatomy, and then seeing what works, and then moving on to the next line pass to keep refining it over and over, you know?
Yeah.
Bruno, thanks for following, dude.
Do you ever think it would be faster if you, I guess, thumbnailed or sketched earlier on or something?
No, I think I don't like to work. I hate drawing small.
Uh huh.
So I like to work really large scale, I think, and so I think that's part of the process. I just kind of like doodle like on like a full size canvas until I find like a gesture or flow that kind of clicks.
Uh huh.
And then I just drop the opacity to 20%. I go to the next layer. I just draw on top, refine, lasso portions. You know. Change proportions, change positions, draw on top of that layer again, drop opacity, keep drawing on top. It's like a constant, just kind of like dropping the opacity and just keep drawing more and more and more on top of it. And just
yeah,
kind
I can
of
see that.
Polishing it further and further.
I can see that.
And dude, yeah, spin. That sounds pretty fucking rad, actually.
Let's see here. Young says, luckily every emote is thumbnailing. That is very true.
Yeah.
Alex the Fluffy Sheep says, thumbnailing is super helpful for planning composition, saves you time before you get into heavy rendering. Yeah, I can agree with that. Young says, I scribble fiercely until something happens and it works out.
I mean, I kind of feel the same way, but like, once I find something that kind of clicks, then I just drop the opacity, I draw right on top, and I just kind of keep cleaning it and refining it.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I kind of find my way through an illustration just through that process. Like, I don't actively thumbnail, like, six ideas, but, like, I just kind of gesture an idea, and I refine it with each pass as I go until I find what actually works, you know? If that makes
sense. Yeah, I could see that. No, I could see that.
Silas, 6 minutes left, by the way. Venus says, I do a few sketchy thumbnails, pick one. I like the most, work on it, end up changing everything on the long time. I think they have to do stuff. Maybe I just don't know how to thumbnail right. I don't know.
I do find doing this, Venus, really helps because, and it lets me kind of sit on something for a little bit too. So like even, so anytime I have an idea, I'll do like a really rough sketch and then I'll drop some colors on it. And then sometimes I have to step away for a while. Like this piece right here, I think I thumbnailed this like 2 months ago.
Did you really?
Yeah, it was when you told me about the contest. Yeah. And so I did this and like I'm finally getting back to it, but this helps me remember everything that was in my head, you know? Sika, hello.
Jimbo says I do a lot of comic panels, so I have to work pose to pose. Yeah, I can see that process there.
Alex says that it also saves you a lot of pain too, since yeah, for traditional I could see that a lot of frustration. Painted Dream says, do you have a channel on Discord for people's art or work in progress? Yes. For the Study Jam one, no, not really, but for our own personal Discords, Painted Dreams, that we both have like a Whips and Crits art sort of channel.
Yes,
that you can post and share stuff to.
Yo, thanks, LLPC. Thanks, dude. Appreciate that. Thanks, Con. Yeah, it's kind of fun. I find myself drawing a lot more lately. Going back to my roots.
Are you getting tired of painting, or do you think you're just kind of, you know, wanting to have the fun of it?
I don't know. I mean, I still enjoy painting, but I'm not burnt out on it, I don't think. Something very just kind of cathartic about just putting lines down.
Okay. Yeah, I wasn't sure, because I know you've had to do so many wedding commissions lately, so I didn't know if, like, it was, like, kind of making you tired.
But... Yeah, yeah, kind of, maybe.
Yeah, you know?
Maybe.
Man, I think I kind of like this.
Yeah?
I may make this into an actual illustration at some point.
You should.
Sorry, I thought Panda Arts was for you. No, I have my own sort of dedicated sellout channel. That's for everyone to post in Painted Dreams. Venus says, I do something similar coloring-wise. I think me changing so much is a bit unavoidable right now because I'm very indecisive. Digital art gives too many options. This is true. This is true. Photoshop should restrict me. You should.
It might
do...
be soon.
Yeah, that's also very true. They'll restrict you in a different way. In a different way, but
by suing your ass.
Yeah. You know what you should try doing, Venus? Is do more traditional. I actually feel like... I feel like traditional actually really forces you to work with limited stuff more. And so when you go and do... when you go back to digital, you're not as all over the place. I think you've been...
Too true to be funny. I know. It's kind of scary, right?
Yeah. I really feel like it's because of that, whatever's going on with Dolby, though. I have a feeling that if you're fairly up to date now and that you don't update your applications, you know, I don't think you're going to get that message. But I think if you're, like, a couple years, you know, not updated, then you might get that message.
Maybe. Thanks, Jorge. I appreciate it, bro.
You should. You're so scared. No, don't be. Don't be honest. And I think this is for any artist. And I think you have agreed with me on this before, James. But, like, I feel like doing traditional and digital really helps you improve quickly.
Oh, yeah. Big time. I think so, too.
Yeah.
There's definitely a benefit to doing both.
Yeah.
I think a lot of it transfers back and forth.
Mm-hmm. I think especially when it comes to coloring, it really freaking helps because you don't have, like, the 20 options you do traditionally that you do digitally, yeah. Right? It's, like, forces you to make decisions.
Well, I mean, it's like any other medium, though. Like, you probably, if you're, like, say, like, a watercolor painter and you experiment into gouache and you go experiment into acrylic or oils, there's going to be things that you're going to be able to pick up and apply your knowledge from each medium to the other, right?
Mm-hmm.
And, I mean, digital art is just another medium.
This is true.
There's going to be things you're going to start thinking... You're basically going to start thinking about things differently as you explore other things. Like, if you start doing, like, traditional, for example, you actually may pick up a different brush or a different color because of what you've learned on digital, vice versa.
Yeah, that's true.
Approaching things with a different mindset. Do a lot of rough sketching on paper. I can always scan in the ones I like for digital. Yeah, it's a good... I can see that for sure. That's probably a workflow for a lot of folks, I'd imagine, right?
Mm-hmm.
I just don't have a good scanner.
Oh!
Dude, time is up. What?
Holy crap. It went from having a lot of time to no time. When did that happen?
Right? What the fuck happened? Guys, you have until 12:08 AM, Eastern, which is 9:08 PM Pacific Pam's time to post your work. We won't be critiquing these because it's kind of hard to critique the work. It's your original little brainchild here, right?
Mm-hmm.
But we'd love to show it off on stream. So if you want to share what you've been working on for the last 90 minutes, feel free to drop it on Discord. If you need a link to the Discord server for Study Jam, do !SJ. And, we'll go over these in, like, 5 minutes. How do you feel about yours, Pam?
I really like mine. I actually really, really like mine. And it's not a fan art. This will actually probably be like one of my first original character digital pieces in a long, long time.
Yeah, that's fucking rad.
I don't know if I should turn her into a fan art, almost. So I could, or maybe I'll just roll with it as it is. I don't know. Maybe I'll Google around and see what kind of characters are out there that are sort of faunish, but I actually kind of really like her how she is, and I kind of like the whole, like, me doing a faun every year kind of thing anyway, yeah. So.
She looks fierce. Yeah, she really does. It's a really good, sort of, like, preliminary sketch on it. I mean, it's not even a preliminary sketch, but, like, I think the colors look great on it, too.
Thank you.
It's got a lot of promise. Yeah, I don't know who you could turn it into if you ever wanted to. I bet you could turn it into a WoW character.
Oh, huh. Like, I bet you, yeah. I can look up druids and stuff like that if I wanted to. Yeah. I may keep it original. Because I haven't done an original piece in a while. Because I've been so focused on all this marketing stuff. So maybe I'll just keep it original.
You could. Time is up, dude. Canvas, time is up. You have 3 minutes to post your work. You should probably post your work before.
Oh, yeah. You're welcome, OBC. I'm glad you really like it.
Yeah, it's tough to say whether or not you should keep it original. Like, I don't know if original pieces sell or not, right? Convention? Like, just thinking from a convention standpoint.
It's 50-50, I feel like. I think there's definitely people who go to conventions, and yeah. All they want is, they actually look for the artists who have original artwork kind of thing.
Okay. Yeah, I guess I don't really know too much about it, but...
But there's also the people, and this is more or so where my concern is because this happened to me so much last year, that the people who like go through your book and they'll love your artwork and they'll say things, and then they'll ask you. They'll ask you that fucking question. It's like, oh, do you have an Anna, or do you have a Tracer? And I'm like, nope. And then they're like, oh, okay. And then they walk away, and I was like, okay.
Yeah, that's the thing. It's like. Such a tough struggle. Like, I know Sarah's talked about it too, but like the personal struggle of doing original, personal, maybe inspiring work, stuff that motivates you, versus doing the work that's gonna potentially sell and be viable commercially, right?
Yeah. So I think if you can do, I do think it's good to do a mixture of both if you can, because I feel like, and I don't think it should be this way, honestly, but it is this way. I do feel like you earn the respect of your fellow peers with original artwork and not fan artwork.
Yeah, I think that's true too. That's definitely true. You guys get 1 minute to post? 1 minute to post?
Polish says, okay, judging from what I've heard, it's more like 30-70 in favor of fan art.
Like 70? Like more people prefer it or no?
I don't know how to read that statistic. I'm sorry.
Or less. I mean, I think 30-70% means that like 30% versus 70%, so 30% of the actual people would actually prefer it. So people are more in favor of original work?
Maybe? I don't know. Did I post? I did post, okay. Let's go ahead and save that so I don't lose it. I'll probably transfer this to another canvas at some point.
I'm censoring, Silas says.
good, Silas, good.
Can't fight with what the fans want. Yeah, I mean, I think you probably can do a lot of original stuff as long as you have the portfolio of fan-related content already under your belt, right? You might just have to kind of, like grit your teeth and just, like, churn out a bunch of, like, fan art stuff over time, you know? And then once you kind of have, like, a decent chunk under your belt, you know? Then move on to more original. You actually may be in a place where you can start doing that too, I think.
Yeah?
Maybe.
We'll see how this year goes. I think I feel a little bit... I mean, I did have a bunch of people who did like my original pieces last year, but I had so many people walk by my booth because I didn't have enough variety of like fan art characters. It made me kind of like a little bit on the insecure side.
Yeah, it's tough.
Yeah, so that's what this year's about, and, you know, I'm trying to do, I guess, the best that I can with it.
Do you want to change topics? Do you want to start showing us off?
Yeah, let me just read what Polish says really quick. He says, I meant to say that 70% of people look for fan art and 30% look for original art. I think I would agree with that.
I gotcha.
Alright, let me scroll to the top really quick.
I think Flo's the first one here.
Yes. Yeah. Okay.
Sure.
Awesome.